The Best Docs Network helps you find some of the best doctors, utilizing the latest procedures and practices in healthcare. Actual patients and the doctors themselves walk you through their stories that together help you make the best decision in your search for the right doctor. On today's episode, prosthodontist Dr. David McFadden talks about complete mouth restoration using implants. ENT Dr. C.T. Nguyen helps his patient find relief from constant sinus infections, headaches, and sinus pressure. Houston Northwest Medical Center features its breast center. Facial plastic surgeon Dr. Yadro Duchik discusses the importance of good skincare for his patients.
So before I met Dr. Duchik, I just felt like my skin was dull and spotty and splotchy and was constantly trying to search for makeups that would make a difference transitioning into my 50s.
Skin care is obviously very, very important. The skin is what everybody sees. They don't see the underlying bone. If we do somebody's rhinoplasty, they're not looking at their cartilages, they're not looking at their jaws, their cheekbones, their eye sockets. They see the skin. That's the first thing that you see. So ideally, you want the skin to look as good as possible.
Typically, Dr. Duchik does like me to see patients before they have surgery. He'll do a consultation and he'll send me in the room and say, please talk to them about skincare. Let's get their skin looking good first, and then we'll, you know, discuss surgery.
I always feel at home when with Jennifer. She is a very well-versed in skincare, and she pays attention to my age, and we stay really focused on what it is that I'm trying to accomplish.
Well, the whole point of doing cosmetic surgery on somebody is to make them look better and feel better about the way they look and more comfortable in their own skin, so to speak. And so one of the first things we always try to do is tune up the skin, make the skin look as good as possible, because then people oftentimes are so happy with their skin that they don't feel like they need to sometimes even do surgery.
As you get older, your body kind of, you lose the collagen in your skin. Collagen's kind of like the springs in a mattress. You start to lose volume, and you'll start to notice fine lines and wrinkles. By stimulating the collagen, your skin will become firmer and the wrinkles will start to dissipate. There's several different things that we offer that help stimulate collagen, one of them being the Dermapen. It creates micro injuries to the skin, and when the skin starts to heal, it starts to rebuild collagen, which is pretty amazing.
And the goal is not to do surgery, the goal is just to make somebody look better.
I no longer have to search for makeups that cover up. I just feel younger than I thought I was going to feel in my 50s, and just feel brighter, and that my skin finally is at a place where it's glowing.
Taking a multivitamin is a quick and easy way to make sure you're consuming the essential vitamins and minerals you may not be getting from food. Make sure your supplement delivers 400 IU of vitamin D, which is the dose that is said to reduce risk of early death by 7%.
Originally, I was having a lot of sinus pressure. Pretty much all the time I had sinus pressure. And I had a lot of headaches. I would have sinus infections pretty much back to back. I'd have several sinus infections a year.
Amanda has consulted multiple Ready Clinic urgent care that does not really address her problem. All they did was to refill her prescription of antibiotics, gave her some antihistamine, and tell her to go home. What they do is they treat her symptoms instead of treating the cause of her problem.
He basically just looked at my nose and kind of tried to figure out what the problems were based on the symptoms. And he noticed immediately that my turbinates were really big.
The inferior turbinate, it's a normal structure in your nose that everybody has. It has a role of filtering and humidifying the air that you breathe in. So it become enlarged and inflamed when it is irritated by either allergies, infection, or pollution in the air. Considering her busy schedule, we decide upon a two-prong approach treatment. Balloon sinuplasty in office to treat her sinus issue, and inferior turbinate reduction to relieve her nasal obstruction.
I don't really have any more sinus issues. I haven't had a sinus infection since the surgery, and it's been a few months now.
The advantage of balloon sinuplasty is that it can be done in office. There's no general anesthesia. The cost is less than doing it in the hospital, and the recovery time is really quick. There's really no downtime. The patient can go back to their daily activities quickly.
It's actually kind of funny. There's a lot of things that I didn't realize were issues until after the surgery. I know one time I was sitting in my bathroom and I was sitting there and there was a candle about 2 feet away from me and I actually could smell it. And that was something that I have never done before, and it kind of just hit me. I was like, I can actually smell the candle.
Best Docs Network doctor and official eye doctor to the Dallas Cowboys, Dr. Harvey Carter, the expert for all your vision needs. See the world differently in only a day, specializing in LASIK, cataracts, and crystal lens. Visit Dr. Carter today for the ultimate eye experience. Call now and receive $2,000 off your LASIK procedure. When seeing is believing. Dr. Harvey Carter, the official eye doctor to the Dallas Cowboys.
In my 20s and early 30s, I had 6 years of fertility treatments before I was able to conceive, followed by uterine cancer when my son was 18 months old. Both of those caused me to gain a great deal of weight, and I put it off and put it off and put it off, not thinking that insurance would ever cover the surgery. And then I went to see Dr. Frenzel, found out that it would be covered by insurance, had the surgery, have lost all of the weight, and I'm going on 3 years post-op now, and it has been wonderful.
We got Stacy approved. Let us do the same for you. Call now and begin your transformation.
Started very early in my 20s to get a lot of dental work, crowns, and then in my 30s I realized it wasn't going to last forever, and this created some problems. Not only is it expensive, but it takes your time and it's uncomfortable.
Implant treatment has really been a great technology for patients whose teeth have reached a point where they can't be restored. Teeth that reach that point either have broken off, have decayed, or are just so broken down that we can't use them anymore in the reconstruction process. In those patients who have reached that point, we recommend removal of the teeth and reconstruction with dental implants. Sue had been plagued by a lifetime of dental problems, including decay and tooth loss. She had reached a point where we did not feel comfortable saving any of her natural teeth, so we decided we'd do a reconstruction for her with dental implants.
My friend Kelly is in the dental educational field, so he's very meticulous and precise. So you always go to the person that's best suited to the job. And in this case, it was a prosthodontist. Kelly said this was the only place to do it, and so this is where we did it. And he was right.
Sue was referred by a very close friend of hers who is a dentist here in Dallas. I was honored to get that referral because they had researched her needs and visited many offices before deciding to come here. What they found in their search was that a lot of the other practices were heavy on sales and very light on education. What they liked about my approach was that I simply gave them their options and was able to show them similar cases so they could make their own decision.
Dr. McFadden is very easy to talk to. He can take a joke, he's got a sense of humor, he's serious when he needs to be. He's very thorough, both in the procedures and also letting you know what's going to happen and how he's doing it.
Many times patients' dental situations have deteriorated to the point where their whole mouth needs to be treated. Many people can't afford that, so we try to stage their treatment in a way that we have good stopping points along the way so they can regroup and plan for the future.
There's two main types of arthritis. There's osteoarthritis and there's rheumatoid arthritis. Osteoarthritis is common, rheumatoid arthritis is not. Osteoarthritis is mild to moderate, rheumatoid arthritis can be a very bad disease. And how do you tell the difference? Well, osteoarthritis is usually wear and tear of weight-bearing joints like the knees, or joints in your hands, the ones that move a lot, like this one right at the base of your thumb. Rheumatoid arthritis involves usually the knuckle joints. It can involve a lot of other different joints, but those are the main ones where they start, and it starts with stiffness. Stiffness in the morning. Now, osteoarthritis results in 15 to 20 minutes of stiffness in the morning. Usually goes away once you get up and move around and sort of oil your joints up a little bit. Rheumatoid arthritis results in sometimes 2 to 3 hours of stiffness. So if you have a lot of stiffness that lasts a long time in the morning, that generally could be rheumatoid arthritis. Again, it's a rarer illness than osteoarthritis, but it's also much worse, and there's a lot that can be done to make it improve and not progress and cause crippling deformities.
Here at Houston Northwest Medical Center's Breast Center, we focus on the patient and giving them the best quality care possible. The Breast Center here at Houston Northwest is a comprehensive breast center, meaning that not only can we do screening mammograms, we can also do the diagnostic portion, ultrasounds, MRIs, and biopsies.
I'm currently the medical director at Houston Northwest Medical Center. My primary role is interpreting screening and diagnostic mammograms, breast ultrasound, and breast MRI for detection of breast cancer. Also to determine clinical issues. If a patient comes in with a palpable lump, we want to find out what it is. Doesn't mean it's going to be breast cancer. It may be a simple cyst, it may be a benign tumor, but that is part of the workup that I'm involved in.
All of our nurses are certified nurse navigators here. They help the patient walk through the system, whether it's just for a screening mammogram or all the way through surgery. They help them navigate their care.
At Houston Northwest Medical Center, we have 4 breast patient navigators. We are very fortunate to be able to do what we do. Very few hospitals in the area have the opportunity to have this many nurse navigators. And from the beginning, from screening, from going out into the community, it's all about deliverance of care and continuity of care. So if you just make sure that that care is not broken, then one passes a torch to the next person to make sure from the time that she got her biopsy, from the time that she got her diagnosis, that we actually use the library to give her all the information that she needs to arm herself before she goes to see the surgeon.
At Houston Northwest Medical Center, we're very fortunate that we have a multidisciplinary breast cancer conference every 2 weeks, so twice a month. Every patient that is diagnosed with breast cancer at this hospital will be presented at a conference that is attended by radiologists, pathologists, breast surgeons, oncologists, radiation oncologists, and plastic surgeons, and the nurse navigators.
This is an excellent way for the patient that has been recently diagnosed have a treatment plan mapped out for her by specialists that come to the breast conference.
The Breast Center at Houston Northwest Medical Center is the only certified center of excellence in Houston, Texas. We have a monthly support group called Care, Share, and Be Aware, where newly diagnosed patients can come and share their feelings. They can also bond with other breast cancer survivors to interact with them and learn from them.
We always say no one chose this journey, but if you're walking the journey, you're not going to walk it alone, because we're going to walk it with you.
Do you have missing teeth, need crowns, veneers, partials, dentures, or a full mouth reconstruction? Prostodontist Dr. David McFadden will give you back the youthful appearance and confidence you deserve. Backed by credibility and credentials, Dr. McFadden is cosmetically changing his patients' lives one smile at a time. Call today or log on to dignitydental.com. DrDavidMcFadden.com. Dr. David McFadden, your go-to dentist in the Dallas-Fort Worth area.
As we see it, advances in medicine have as much to do with patient comfort as with medical technology. Oh, at Forest Park Medical Center, we invest in medical technology as much as any hospital in North Texas. It's just that we invest in other things as well. You see, Forest Park Medical Center was designed for warmth, designed for comfort, designed for, dare we say it, our patients. Come see for yourself what medical care should be. Forest Park Medical Center, your destination to better health.
Coming up on the second half of today's show, vein specialist Dr. Peter Morgan discusses his methods for treating those with restless leg syndrome. Bariatric surgeon Dr. Scott Stowers changes his patient's life with a lap band procedure. Oral surgeon Dr. Paul Metz improves his patient's life with dental implants. Minimally invasive spine surgeon Dr. Douglas Wan talks about his approach to spine care.
And we welcome you inside the Best Docs Network studio. We are happy to be joined by Dr. Doug Wan. And when it comes to spine and neck surgery, this is your go-to doctor. He is also the director and founder of Spine Care. Dr. Wan, welcome to the program.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Let's start it off with your philosophy when it comes to your approach to medicine. What would that be?
So we practice medicine based on, our approach is very patient-centric, providing the best care for the patient. And when it comes to spine care, spine problems are a very complex issue. And so our approach is to approach it with a very comprehensive approach. So in our center, we have from the least invasive way to the most complex way of treating spine conditions. And we have providers such as chiropractors, physical therapists, physical medicine rehab doctors, interventional pain specialists, and minimally invasive spine surgeons. And we approach it through a multidisciplinary approach and find the best way to treat the patients so that they get the most amount of pain relief.
All right, doctor, what was your goal in creating Spine Care? What did you have in mind?
When we created Spine Care, our goal is to provide the best kind of spine care to the patients. There are many patients with very complex spine problems. However, not everyone may need spine surgery. So we approach the spine through a multidisciplinary approach, and we find the best way to treat the patients with significant back pain. That's why we have from the chiropractor to physical therapist, physical medicine rehab doctors, interventional pain specialists, and minimally invasive spine surgeon. We find the right diagnosis and treat the patient the right way and the least invasive way possible so that they can get their life back as soon as possible. Also at the Spine Care, we have high level imaging so that patients do not have to travel elsewhere to get their imaging studies done. Also, we have our own procedure centers on campus, so therefore they can not only get the evaluation, but also pain procedures done, as well as spine surgery.
To see the rest of this interview, as well as other outstanding videos, head to bestdocsnetwork.com.
My legs were very, very tired. I couldn't sleep, toss and turn, couldn't get comfortable. They would just hurt and all night for years.
Restless legs is best described as a very strong sensation or urge to move your legs. It becomes disabling because it creates an anxious sensation. It's hard to explain. You're not sure what's causing it. You just have this overwhelming urge to move your legs. It almost always occurs at night, and because of that, it creates severe insomnia and severe anxiety.
I had varicose veins. I knew I could see them on the outside. I didn't know about the veins on the inside that were not allowing the blood flow to go past my knees. That would just go up so far and then just go back down to my feet.
We mapped her veins very carefully using ultrasound. We again isolated all the bad veins, the ones that were too large and the blood was running backwards because the valves had failed. And then we selectively ablated those using radiofrequency under ultrasound guidance.
No pain, just a little stinging when they first go in with it, but really not much. Even though they say, well, it's not gonna hurt, it's not gonna hurt, but it really didn't. The last treatment I had, I didn't feel a thing.
And we do that without any incisions or anesthesia. The patients can walk in, sit down, have the procedures done, stand up, walk out, get in their car, and drive themselves home.
I would say don't worry about it, just do it. Just get it done because you need to have it taken care of. Sleeping now, I rest comfortably, and it turned out good.
In the past, we used surgical procedures. Problems with that, one, it required general anesthetic. Two, it required big cuts with potential side effects like infection, damage to nerves, arteries, muscle, and they weren't selective. We were almost randomly choosing veins to treat, and they weren't always the only or maybe even the correct veins to treat. Now we selectively treat only the veins that are running backwards, so it works much better.
I've experienced in my past excessive weight gain. I would diet, lose, gain, lose. I was embarrassed. I was ashamed. I didn't feel good, and the more I gained, the less I felt confidence. I had made the choice that I needed to really make the decision to change my life, to get my health back on track.
Charlotte had a Lap-Band procedure, which is one of the most common procedures that we do. She's been very successful for her. She lost her predicted weight that she wanted to, and the several different medications she took, she doesn't take anymore.
I decided to have the bariatric lap band at My Bariatric Solutions. I have a lot more energy. I strive to do things that I wouldn't have before, experience some exciting things on some of my travels.
A band is put in laparoscopically through small incisions in the skin. We put the band around the top of the stomach, and it's a balloon, essentially. It has a port that goes up under the skin, and we can put salt water in there to tighten the band up. That keeps the food in the top of the stomach and makes people feel not hungry with a small amount of food. It works like a long-term diet, only you feel full with small amounts of food. The most important part of a band patient doing well is frequent follow-ups and getting their band adjusted, especially early on. First 6 months, we will normally do about 5 adjustments until they learn how to use the band. After that, maybe one every 6 months, and then later on, maybe once a year.
My experiences with Dr. Stowers and his staff is so easy. I arrive, I'm seen in a timely manner, in a professional manner, and people are so friendly, and they treat me as a family. Each time is very special, and I look forward to seeing the doctor. He's very friendly, very cordial, and very professional all at the same time.
Missing teeth, need crowns, veneers, partials, dentures, or a full mouth reconstruction? Prostodontist Dr. David McFadden will give you back the youthful appearance and confidence you deserve. Backed by credibility and credentials, Dr. McFadden is cosmetically changing his patients' lives one smile at a time. Call today or log on to DignityDental.com. Dr. David McFadden, your go-to dentist in the Dallas-Fort Worth area.
I didn't feel good about myself, and I never wanted to go anywhere. Now my world has opened up. I occasionally go out with my girlfriends, and we have a great time together.
I was getting older and didn't really care about my weight, but my doctor said I needed to do something immediately. Now I'm spending time with my grandchildren, and every moment seems special.
My one reason was to live life again.
My one reason was to simply live.
So what's your one reason?
Barker Bariatric Center. Log on or call today for your consultation.
Best Docs Network doctor and official eye doctor to the Dallas Cowboys, Dr. Harvey Carter, the expert for all your vision needs. See the world differently in only a day. Specializing in LASIK, cataracts, and crystal lens. Visit Dr. Carter today for the ultimate eye experience. Call now and receive $2,000 off your LASIK procedure. When seeing is believing. Dr. Harvey Carter, the official eye doctor to the Dallas Cowboys.
You notice something about Forest Park Medical Center the moment you walk through the front door. Gone are the smells, the sights, and the sounds that are typically associated with most hospitals. And in their place is something decidedly different. You see, Forest Park Medical Center was designed to be comfortable, inviting, even calming. Fact is, many of our patients don't want to leave. Come experience for yourself what medical care should be. Forest Park Medical Center, your destination to better health.
If you can work up a sweat for just 1 hour a week, you can reduce your risk of heart attack, improve overall mood, and lower blood pressure.
The ideal patients for dental implants are ones that have been through lots of restorative procedures, and they're where these procedures that just aren't predictable. And so we were able to give them their third set of teeth with the use of dental implants.
I had an accident when I was 10 years old, and I fell down on my face and I dislocated my jaw. And I didn't know that then, but I started looking for the oldest doctor or the one with 35 years or more of experience. So I went to the facility in Gessner and I saw Dr. Metz, and they said, this is the guy who's gonna have to be working on you. I had to decide if I wanted to go through with it, and I did research. He graduated top in the class.
So in Tico, we were able to move his upper jaw forward and set his lower jaw back so as to help line up his skeleton so that his teeth meshed together well. We, as specialists in oral surgery, are uniquely qualified to provide these procedures.
I just figured out this is the best facility, this is the best doctor, and I truly believe that, you know, Dr. Metz and his team, they know what they're doing.
These patients, when we know when they come down the hallway, when we see them after this procedure, we see their level of confidence has gone up tremendously. We can tell by the smile on their face as well as their dress. They're dressed sharply and they're holding their chin up. You can certainly tell that they are happier individuals afterwards. Technology today has, you know, really revolutionized how we practice implant dentistry. We have cone beam CTs, which allow us to take a CT of the patient in the office, and in about 20 seconds, we have 360 degrees of bone around the implant. So we know ahead of time whether we need to graft, and also the type of grafting that we need to do ahead of time. So patients are better prepared for the experience and know more of what to expect afterwards. We're able to do this in a safer fashion. And it's much more rapid. The procedures are much more rapid, and the recovery is much easier as well.
Didn't find the doctor you're looking for on today's episode? Head to our website, bestdocsnetwork.com. There you can search our video library by topic, specialty, and doctor. The Best Docs Network, helping you find the right doctor and bringing medical education to you.